Welcome everyone to the self-installation video for the OzRoo rack provided by our good friends over at PPD Performance. They provide a lot of other forward driving gear, so make sure you check out their website, have a look through all their stuff. They've got some really great gear and some really great stuff there that'll look after you. Coming up, some video that I've recorded, some audio that's going to help make your install easier and faster. So we'll switch to that video of me talking through some quick pointers, and then we'll cut back to this video and we'll talk you through the rest. Hey guys, just wanted to make this quick short video to add at the start of the self-installation. Although mine's pretty much been done, I wanted to make this points so that it's easier for you to do when it comes to you doing a self-install if you want to. As you see in the pictures, you get a giant big bag of bolts that's all filled up. And they mostly consist of these smaller ones. Now, it doesn't specify in the instructions anything about what type of size bolts or so forth are in there and where they're supposed to go. So it's a bit of looking at the pictures and guesswork. And I figured out that obviously these bigger ones, due to their size, if you want to look at you can tell the difference like that. And you can have a look at the difference between the type of Allen keys to do it if you were to tighten manually. The black one's 5mm, the silver one's about 8mm, so it's quite a bit of a difference between the two. And if you've got a drill and a drill set, you're more than likely going to get a hex driver like this that you're able to tighten up the smaller bolts with a drill, which is so much faster and easier. So I'd recommend going out and buying a hex driver that fits the bigger bolt size, even if you take it in and do it that way, to make sure you're getting the right size. You're also going to need a 10mm drill bit that is able to make the holes for the structural bolts to basically go through for your 3 points. So 1, 2, and 3. And these are the bolts that you're going to use. That's the big one and that's the little one. This is a 12mm, that's the 16mm. You can probably get away with a slightly higher size on each with your wrenches or sockets. It'll still grab, but those are the sizes. I also recommend not using sockets with an extension and socket wrench, so you can get into these hard to reach places, which is extremely difficult with a wrench to get in there. But if you put a socket with an extension, you're able to get in there easy and tighten it up, even if you're using an Allen key. But if not, I'd recommend using a socket wrench with your drill and the appropriate hex bit. Finally, these U-shapes, I still haven't quite figured out what they're used for. I thought they were designed, because they don't specify in the instructions, to fill the gap that's left between your tub tray and the actual rack itself, because I wanted to keep mine flush with the outside of my tray, but it does not fit the bigger size bolts through this little U. Does fit the smaller one, it goes through nicely, but the bigger ones, they do not fit. So as yet, I do not know what they're for, and I've completed the whole thing, so yeah, still no idea what they're for. That's pretty much most of it. I'll put a quick list in the description of the sizes I've mentioned, so it's easier for you when you go to do your own self-install if you go out and get these things prior to. That way it's faster and easier using your drill and using a socket wrench. You'll get the job done in a lot quicker time than I did, with a lot less frustration as well. So that's some key points, just primarily for the tub rack portion. The rest of it will be in the video. As I build, I'll talk and give you some tips and stuff that I picked up as I went along. So I'll leave that for now for the instructions for the start and your prep work, and we'll go from there into the next portion of it.
Alright guys, with this one, pause on these pictures as you need to, because my verbal won't be able to keep up with the change of the videos. Particularly on this one, I have a picture there that you can pause and look at, so you can see exactly what is required if you want to do this yourself. at minimum, and what I would recommend that you get to make the job easier as well. Also included some pictures from the instruction book to get you an idea of what I had to work with and what you'd have to work with to put this together. And this is half the reason this video is coming together, so that hopefully you won't need to go through some of the issues I had to get yours together, and it's done quick and easy. I had to use a lot of those images as references to figure some stuff out and work out what goes where. Now, as you've seen in the picture just gone, I actually, you see my bars and the old soft cover. Now, your ute could be, vehicle could be different and have different covers or type of, well, anything really. But the purpose is that you need an area where those structural mount point go to be straight onto the tray so nothing can be there. So what I'm doing is I'm drilling out the pop rivets that's holding these aluminium clips into place. And once I do that, I then carefully and slowly take each and every single one off, because there's tape sticking it down onto the top frame, because I wanted to reuse these aluminium pieces for my soft cover later. So I don't want to damage that, and neither do I want to damage my vehicle. A couple of quick things. If I get a chance, I might swap between a few topics, because sometimes the video catches up to me and I don't get a chance to mention a few things. So I sometimes drift off and mention something and then jump back to what's going on with the video. It's just so I can make sure I'm getting every piece of information that might be useful into the video. So yeah, I do this nice and easy and nice and slow. This may not be maybe not be required for you, but I just put it in to demonstrate that something like this may be required for your car, and the fact that that's a probability, especially for installing this. So this is unwrapping the box with the OzRoo tub rack in it, and you can clearly identify which pieces go where. So it makes sense, because you can see the back has the brand name with the two spots for the LED lights. Fantastic they included those, and I'll probably do a separate separate installation video on how to get those running and working. I think, because that would be a fantastic thing to have happen. At the moment, they're just attached. Now you get the four rails, they're all exactly the same. You get a different front bracket that looks distinct, so you know that goes to the front. You get the four odd L-shaped items, and then the four mounting bracket points. I often interchangeably say mounting bracket points or strut mounts, so forth. I just use that word interchangeably. It just means that same piece. So forgive me if I chop and change the terms, but that's what I'm talking about. So you can clearly sort of see which bits go where. The only issue is, once you're finished, you're left with a giant big bag of bolts, and then there's stray of U-shaped metal pieces that I still haven't quite figured out where they go. When I looked at the big giant bag of bolts, most of what you can see there is all those small ones, and I didn't actually notice there are bigger ones, not in length but in diameter. And so you guys, when it comes to installing your structural mount points in, you have to pick and choose which one's going to be the longer one, which one's going to be the short, because there's not enough to do all short and all long. They do leave spares in the bag. You end up with quite a lot of spares of all of the nuts, but it's hard to know. Well, I didn't know at first that the big ones go in the structural points. I just thought they're all the same bolts until I looked at the distance of the gap and I realized the small one only just catches it. So I don't think that's going to be quite sturdy. And then I looked at further and I emptied the bag out and I saw the bigger ones and realized that's where they're supposed to go. So a bit of a trial and learn, really. So I'm trying to pass this on so that you guys don't run into that sort of trouble yourself. Now, they say in the instructions that this is what they call a modular system, so that you can put it together any way, which way. There's no set way of doing it. You could, unlike the way I'm doing it at the moment, you could probably put it on the ground, do it up all together, then place it on your tub, and then mark the holes that you're going to have to drill for the bolts to go down to hold the tub onto your tray. But because I had Triton had drilled a hole just up the front where you can see that bracket sticking out in the video, there was a hole there and there was a bolt there that fit perfectly in that spot. So I was like, I'm not wasting and making an extra one, I'll just use that. So I've decided to put mine together like this and follow the instructions by starting with the back piece first. So each and every nut, they say, should be put, have WD-40 on it. I put just some grease on it instead. And then I like to have the hex bolt facing out for more the aesthetics look. It looks nicer and looks cleaner. And the other side, you have the washer and the nut, which you hand tighten up until you can't tighten it up anymore, which is just enough so that it holds the structure together. And once you've got a few of those in, even though it can still move a bit, it holds its shape. So it enables you to both maneuver it on the back of the tub, because in a bit you'll see that I look at the, realize that the OzRoo and the lights aren't really centralized. So I have to undo a couple of nuts a little bit and allow it to move across slightly so it sits in the middle. So that's one of the good things about where you can adjust this depending upon what vehicle you're in. It's not restrictive. Now, for me to figure out how to get the exact holes to be able to drill for the rear structural mount, so you use the side rails that are going to be placed, and I butt them up against the front structural mount point and where I have my rear bracket, rear bar already set. So I use that gun to make the marks so I can drill the holes for the structural bolts to go down. And that's how I did mine. Then I take that off and drill the holes out. And that's how I did mine that way. So you can do yours separately, but I suggest there's still a lot of the information I've already mentioned will still make, even if you did it a different way, will still be helpful to have some of the bits and pieces of this knowledge so that you can get yours done faster and easier, particularly with some of these issues. Now, I'm drilling the vertical bolts on this one at the moment, and particularly problematic in these trays is towards both the back and the front. It starts to bulge out the metal from the frame into the tray slightly, so you're left with little room in those corner sections, and your tub gets very close to those corner sections, and there's only a small gap between the outside of the tub in the frame of the vehicle and the little bit of metal that you're working with to be able to get your bolts up into that space, which is why I recommended using a hex bit to hold the hexes hex bit for the drill, but the socket wrench so you can actually get up into those smaller gaps. So you can see I'm drilling some holes for the rear mounts. I recommend doing it that way with the socket wrench to get in there. I did see in some of their pictures with the really, really hard to reach spots, particularly where you can't get even a socket wrench in, they actually flip it and had the bolt on the top, and they've used the Allen key portion to try and fit up to get to the tiny space. So you may have to do that yourself too. I had to do that to one of my my front ones. The very front pair had to be done that way because it was too close to the way the metal frame came out. It's just something that may happen, so it's just something to be aware of. So I'm pretty much going around adding all the extra bolts, because each piece needs to have, each part that connects to another part has two bolts either side, so four bolts in total holding each section together. And then at the moment what I'm doing is I'm trying to align the rear of the OzRoo with the lights to be centralized with my vehicle, and align the outside of the structural mounts with the tub so it all looked flush. So essentially that's what was going on. And it allows you to have that leeway, depending on your tub size, to see whether or not you need to make yours short or longer to accommodate that. Mine's a half height tub as well, so you can get higher ones, but I wanted mine a bit lower. At the moment I'm just fiddling around with the front mount and making sure the nut's done up so that I can then look at building the front bracket portion that'll go on those structural mounts. This is essentially copy and paste from what you did in the rear, except you're doing it for the front. So same sort of construction that goes on here. So all of this part is pretty much, once you've figured out the issues with the bolts and so forth, and worked out how to do the easy portions of it, it becomes faster and not as complex. But with those simple pointers right at the start, would have made this job go a lot faster than it ended up being, particularly when you realize you've made an error with the bolts and find different sizes. And if I didn't mention already, you may, with those different size structural bolts, there's small length and long length ones. So there's not enough smalls or longs to do all those structural points with the shorts, all those structures with the longs. So you're going to have to try and work out which one is going to work best for you in which situation, and utilize both types for whatever reason. Once I've finished putting the front one together, I'm going to sit it on top of the mounting brackets at the front, and then basically do the same thing where I put a hand bolt in. These slide straight over top of the structural mount point, so it actually makes it easier to place on. So I've got to say, when it comes to the construction portion of it, it is simple and straightforward. It just means if you had that information in the instructions about with a little bit more of some of these type of images, where you're going, all right, I need to add X amount of bolts here, and this bolt goes there, and these bigger bolts are designed for here, you would have, and it just makes it easier. And you don't have to then try and make mistakes and then try and fix it afterwards, or not realize how it all goes together. Place the front one on. You've got the option to have it higher and lower. As I mentioned, this is a half height one, but there is one more hole slightly further down, so I can drop it a little bit further down. The real reason was I was hoping that when I put the roof tent on, if it was low enough, I'd be able to get it in there in my garage without any issues. Unfortunately, as soon as I put the ladder on, it would just a fraction too high, so I may move this down a little bit more, but I like the height that it sits at the moment, and I like the fact you can change it. So I drill the vertical points on the other strut for the other side, and then do the same thing where you put the nut in and grease and washer and nut. Sometimes they also say nut when I meant bolt, so but you get what I mean. Now I go about adding all the ones that need to be added to make all this structurally sound. Like I said, four for each side. Now also, I apologize at the moment here for some of my camera work with the head cam. Because I'm moving a fair bit with my actions and what I'm doing, when I speed this video up, unfortunately it overemphasizes that action and just creates a bit of blurriness to the video, so I apologize for that. So at this point, I'm pretty much putting up my top rails. This is the rails that are really important because my roof rack's going to be sitting on those, taking most of the weight. So you gotta spread them out, make sure they've got their strength, and you're doing all the bolts up that you need to, which is one goes down the vertical and you have two horizontal ones either side of each rail. So it's quite a few bolts going in, and each single one of those needs to be done up. Use your drill wherever you can, but there are places that you're going to unfortunately not be able to, which are the ones right close up to the rail. And in the picture, if you see the back of my window or back of my ute and where the tub is or starts, you can see, well, you can't quite tell, but the drill doesn't fit in that gap. So I had to do all those bolts by hand. There were a lot of them. And I used a wrench as well, because I didn't go out and get a socket wrench. And that makes it a bit harder to hang on to the nut properly whilst you're trying to tighten it manually with an Allen key, which takes a lot of time. So save as much time by using the right side of equipment wherever possible. And particularly with the corner areas, if I forgot and haven't mentioned already, those really hard to reach corners, especially at the front, I had to, instead of putting the hex facing up, I actually had to put the hex underneath, because there was that shorter space that I had to put that under to hold that wire, tighten the top bolt on. I just don't like the look. I like everything to be the same. It's probably just the OCD in me. Anyway, then you just put the side railings on, and then you just tighten the frame up all in general. And once everything's tightened and every bolt's done up, and I check every bolt has been done up, then jump on it, I swing off it, I rock it off, rocking back and forward. I couldn't make it move. It was sturdy and went together. You'll see an image coming up where you get a view from underneath where you see that gap that I said that we're working with. Very difficult to get into. That's why I recommended those examples at the start and throughout this video, and why the backs, certain ones might need an Allen key and tighten up. Lastly, a couple of things before I finish up, there'll be a few pictures, but I want to be a big shout out to PPD and Canopy Off-Road. Go check their website out, or go into the store. They have a lot of four-wheel drive products, not just this sort of stuff. And they're a great team there. Let them know that we sent to you down there, and hopefully they'll help you out as they always have done so. So there'll be another video of installing the tent. It won't be anywhere near as long because it's not as complex, but the instructions are still lacking, and it did make it kind of difficult to figure out. So that video is coming next, but this is pretty much the tub rack itself. So I hope you got something out of the video. Hope it makes your install easier when it comes to your turn. And if you've got any feedback, pop it in the comments. Let me know what you think. Like and subscribe. And then don't forget, check out PPD Performance on the website or in the store. And a big shout out for that. And I think we'll pretty much leave it here. And I will see you on the video for the tent.